everyone. In this video, we're going to do a very quick overview of all the features and functionality that the basic edition of Simply Schedule Appointments has to offer. So to get started, this is not a full setup tutorial. This is going to be a live demo of booking an appointment, how you would manage it, and some of the highlight features for it. So to start off, I have a agency demo site pulled up here. And here under my contact page, I have a booking form. So here you can see I have the option to select a date. In this case, let's click Sunday, and then I can choose a time slot. And lastly, we have a booking form for your customer to fill out. Now, the basic edition comes with a predetermined set of fields, as you can see here. If you would like to make custom information fields for your form, you can upgrade to one of the premium editions. Even the basic edition has you pretty much covered for the majority of the information that you would really require for a meeting with the customer. So I'm going to go ahead and fill this out, and then when we're done, I'll show you how you would manage it. All right, so I went ahead and filled it in. So now let's book this appointment. So once the appointment's been submitted, you'll see that we have a confirmation screen here. And we have a quick overview of all the information we entered. If your client sees this and is like, oh, I need to change my city or something, I misspelled something, they can always click edit information. If they realize they don't like this time and day, they can reschedule it to a new time, or they can decide to cancel it right here. If I click schedule a new appointment, it takes me back to that first date selection screen. And if I select save to calendar, it'll prompt them to add this booking to their calendar. So if I select Google Calendar, we can quickly take a look and see what that does. All right, so now that I have my Google Calendar pulled up, it automatically fills in a lot of the information for them. So the title of the event, the time frame for it, as well as, let me move myself, as well as the description. They also have a link to reschedule this on their own. And then it's automatically marked as busy. And then you can see here that it autofills the Zoom meeting link that I had entered for that calendar. All right, so now let's head back to Simply Schedule Appointments and see how you would manage it. All right, so to get to the dashboard, you would go to the WordPress dashboard, and from here you can go to the Appointments tab. You can see that we also have a little dashboard widget that you can drag and drop into place wherever you want, but it autofills with all your upcoming appointments. So you can see here the appointment I just booked with Natalie. I can open the web meeting link from here, or I can view the details, which will just take me to the SSA dashboard. So let's head over there right now. And from here, you can see that my new appointment is registered here in my upcoming appointments tab. Just as a quick overview, we have a few different tabs here, including the appointments tab where all your past appointments, all your upcoming appointments live. You can also search, you can filter by the calendars, by the labels, by the statuses too. And then you can also export or create a calendar subscription feed from here as well. And you can also book an appointment as an admin. Next, we have the appointment types tab. This is where all the booking calendars live. So each one of these represents a booking calendar and all its rules and its availability. So if we select consultation phone call, I can give you a quick overview of what that editor looks like. So this is the basics tab. This is where you enter the name of the calendar, the duration. You can also add in instructions, and you can change the layout between weekly or monthly. Next, we have the availability tab. This is where you can enter your weekly availability. And we have this nifty little drag and draw tool that you can use to easily enter in your hours that way. We also have the specific start times option, which if you're very picky about when your time slots appear on your calendar, then you can use that option. And then we also have different intervals, as little as every 10 minutes, or you can have it up to 60 minutes. All right, next we have the scheduling options tab. Notice I skipped the capacity tab because this is only just a reminder that we do offer this option, although it's only available in the premium editions of the plugin. So if you would like to book group appointments, for example, this would be where you would set it. Next, we have scheduling options. This is where you can set the time zone if you'd like it to auto detect the customer's time zone, or if you want to lock it to your personal time zone, you can do that from here. We also have a few other options that help you tailor your schedule for this specific booking calendar. For example, you can add a little bit of padding between each time slot. Here I have it set to 1 hour. And then next we have the notice required setting, just gives you a minimum notice required for each time slot so that you don't have any very last minute bookings. And we have a per day limit set here too, so I can specify how many I would like to take of these per day. Next we have the web meetings, and as you saw earlier in my Google Calendar event, this is where you can enter a personal Zoom meeting room or a Jitsi link, and you can automatically include this in all your appointments so that your customer can have this on hand. Next we have the customer information tab. As I mentioned earlier, these are a preset for the free basic edition, but it does include most of the necessary fields, including the phone, address, city, state, zip code, and notes. And then you can mark some of these as required if you absolutely need to have some of this information for your appointment. And lastly, you have the notifications. It's basically just a list of all the notifications that are going to be triggered and sent out for this specific booking calendar. And if you need to edit any of them at any point, you can click this edit button. And lastly, at the very bottom of the page, we have the booking info. This is how you can embed this specific booking calendar onto your WordPress pages. Using this little short code, you can easily copy it and paste it into place. All right, so that is the appointment type editor. And lastly, with the free basic edition, we do not limit the number of appointment types that you can create. So you can create as many calendars as you need, depending on your services, or you'd like to vary the number of durations you'd like to offer for your clients. It's completely up to you. Next, we have the settings tab, and the free basic edition does include quite a bit of options here. If you scroll further down the page, you can see that some of these are blocked out due to those only being available in the premium editions. But anyway, we have the general settings, just basic information about your business, your admin email, and the formats that you would prefer for your date and times. Then we have the styles, so you can set the default styles from this panel here, for example, the accent color and the background color. And you can also set the font from here. If you'd like to get a little bit more customized with your booking calendars, and we have a custom CSS option here as well too. Next, we have the translation. So Simply Schedule Appointments is translation ready, and some of the more popular languages include German, French, Spanish, and we have a few other ones here as well that you're welcome to browse through and contribute to as well, since we're using the WordPress translation system. Next, we have the advanced scheduling options, which we won't get into in this video, but just know that we do have a few additional options that you can add to the appointment type editor using this little toggle here. And if your appointment types do not depend on each other, meaning that they can run side by side without causing any issues to your business, then you can turn on this independent availability option as well. All right, so going back, we have the notifications. Again, you can send an unlimited number of email notifications. We do offer SMS, but that is for our Pro and Business editions. But you can create as many notifications as you want. You can tie different notifications to the different booking calendars, and you can edit different things, including the, like I mentioned, the appointment types that they're tied to, the trigger. You can edit the subject and the message, and then when you're done, you can view a live rendition of what you just wrote. So here, this is what the message would look like for Natalie, and this one is being sent to the admin. You can also enter custom emails here as well, and send it to whoever you'd like. It's not just limited to the admin or the customer. Alrighty, next we have the blackout dates feature. So in case you need to take a vacation or anything, you can come in here and block off entire days for all your booking calendars just by clicking into the days here. And next we have the calendar events. So like I showed you earlier, once I booked that appointment, I saved that booking to my Google Calendar. And this is where you would be able to adjust what that customer sees when they save it. So I can change the event title for them, I can change the location for them, and I can also edit all the details that are included for that calendar event. Now, if you upgrade to one of our premium editions, more customization options are going to be available here, since you'll be able to have the official Google Calendar sync feature enabled. So next we have the support tab. So we offer all of our customers free support, including users of the free basic edition. So this would be the easiest and best way to contact us, by going to support and using our little contact support form. From here, you can enter your message, you can include more information that would make it very easy for us to troubleshoot, and include a list of your active plugins in case it turns out to be some kind of plugin conflict that we need to address. And that should be about it. Just a quick recap, Simply Schedule Appointments lets you create a free booking calendar for your WordPress websites. And this includes basically everything you need to run a very simple booking system, including the ability to book unlimited appointments, create unlimited booking calendars, and also styling options, blackout dates, email notifications, and a management portal for you to review all your appointments and see what you have coming up next. Simply Schedule Appointments is a WordPress-only booking plugin, so we're completely dedicated to making sure that this is the best booking experience for your customers and for yourself on your WordPress website. We hope this was helpful. Please check out the links in the description box below. I've included a bunch of resources, including a link to our help center, a link to our website, and a link to contact us if you need any help or if you have any questions. We're always happy to review any of your requirements or let you know if this would be a good fit or not. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day.